Good to see everybody. Before we get started, I'd just like to congratulate the Iowa Hawkeyes and Caitlin Clark for getting to the national championship. I'm an old Hawkeye, so it's a little sense of pride there. But just really, really excited to be back out on the field this spring. We're 3 weeks in already, which is amazing how fast it goes. But we've just taken this spring with a very specific approach of some areas where we wanted to see improvement from our team. And, you know, for us, we want to see improvement running the football, stopping the run defensively. We want to see improvement taking care of the football, not having turnovers really specifically. We've really worked on situational football. We're working on end-of-game scenarios. We did a two-minute today. And just really, you know, kind of gone back old school. You know, just we're talking about effort. We're talking about detail. We're talking about finish. And those are the things that I was raised on in this game. And it really comes down to that when the season comes to play. In those tough moments during the year when you got to find ways to get over the hump, comes down to effort, comes to detail, comes down to finish. And so we're just really focusing on those things. I think we're coming very close as a team. You know, in this day of transfers and all this talk about NIL and all this, football's still a game of continuity and experience, and we've got – you know, we got 8 starters back on offense. We got 7 on defense. All our kickers and returners are back. And we just believe that continuity is going to start building on itself, and we're going to continue to build our program that way. Recruiting young players, developing them into good players that love to be here at CSU. So today was a good day, you know, really good scrimmage. We're starting to see a lot of things we're asking our guys to do in practice carry over to the scrimmage field, and we just want to build on that.
Was there a purpose or a goal that you went in specifically today looking for, and did you feel like that goal was met?
Yeah, that's we had a very specific plan of what we wanted. We wanted to get about 6 series of in-the-field scrimmage to see our guys play. We went some short yardage, goal line, and we scrimmaged in the red zone. We did a 2-minute today, and it's always good to do 2-minute when we have officials. And we're really focusing on our end-of-game decision-making, our end-of-game coverages, our end-of-game strategies, and putting our players in those situations so we can coach and learn from it. So that was really good today. I thought that was good on both sides. And, you know, I'm really proud. You know, we got guys like Boom Jock. You know, he was a young kid a year ago, and now he's really kind of the heart of our defense and showing a lot of maturity. You know, Noor Gatooth. You know, a lot of our good young players are starting to grow and mature and become the type of players that we want them to be, especially on defense. And so really proud of that. Really proud of Braden. You know, Braden has developed. He's definitely our leader on our football team now, along with some of our seniors that we have. But he's just shown so much growth in his maturity. His comfort level is like night and day. You can just see it in his body language. He knows exactly what he wants to do with the football. And his leadership has grown, you know. And I told him, I said, you got to remember, you're the quarterback of the whole team, not just the offense. And he's really we've seen a lot of growth in him in the last couple months.
That one and Boom also, they both raved about the running game, how much it's improved. That you said that's one of your goals for this spring.
You know, we've been the top passing team in our league, and we really want to be in more control of games, and we want to be able to run the football. We want to be physical. And we just feel like if we can improve that, we're going to be very dangerous as a team. And, you know, and I think, you know, as a head coach, we're looking at all the factors it takes to win. the more we can control the football, the more we can play the run well, we become in more control of games. And that's really important. And I think, you know, it shows the maturity of our team, too. We're much more physical in our offensive line. We have depth in our offensive line. And, you know, as our program matures, you can see the development in the lines. And it just wasn't like that when we first got here. And, you know, when you have a good program, you're good up front. You're good from the inside out. And that's what we – that's what we're really focusing on.
Has there been a running back that stuck out to you throughout camp so far?
I think we have very good running backs. You know, we were in a situation last year, we were really thin, so we tried to go out and bring guys in. And now we got a bunch of guys at that position. But I love Justin Marshall. I love Damian Henderson. I love Kobe Johnson. I love and Avery Morrow's been fantastic. And so I think we have guys that can make chunk runs. I think we guys can give us big plays in the running game. And that's what we've been missing from our offense is just that punch in the running game that you can hang your hat on and allow us to be more patient with the running game too. And so really proud of how our offensive line has developed this spring. And we're spending a lot of time at it. I mean, we're really investing time and working on that part of our game and making our guys more technically sound and fundamentally sound in those areas.
On that O-line, obviously, when you came in, you sort of had to, you know, bring in some guys that could play immediately because of what you have. But how important is it now that you do have some of those guys that, you know, you and Bill have brought in and started developing that they're starting to, you know,
I just think we've been able to bring in some older transfer guys, but the guys we brought in are multi-year players. So it's not like we have them 1 year and they're gone. We have them a couple of years, and a guy like Drew Moss has been one of our best linemen we've had, but he's been a multi-year player for us. I just believe in continuity. It's hard to play this game if guys haven't played together. You know, and you get all these transfers, and then you end up finding out game 4 or 5 what they're really about. That's what happens in this era of transfer football. You don't know what you have until you start playing games, and you get in tough situations, and then guys' personalities start showing. So, you know, I'm a believer in continuity, and I'm a believer in bringing in kids and working with them for several years. And and obviously the transfer is part of football now and everybody's dealing with it, but it's a much better situation when you have kids for multi-years and you can continue to work with them.
Are you seeing some guys, you know, like a Goody has jumped out, you know, Drew Rodriguez made some plays, guys that are taking advantage of, you know, maybe an older guy that's, you know, not out there right now?
There's no doubt. And, you know, it's spring is, you know, guys get nicked up in the spring. We got a lot of physical practices in a row. And it's an opportunity for young guys to show what they can do. And, you know, practice was designed that way. We wanted to see the young players get opportunities. But we're also challenging them because we're going to have a whole bunch of new guys coming in, and they may not get the same chances in the fall. So take advantage of the chances you have now.
Does that schedule in September, you've played on teams and coached in programs where you get better as you go?
Yeah.
You got kind of an interesting first month, and similar to last year. But do you need to have guys, I guess, hitting the ground running fast?
Absolutely.
You talk about not knowing guys in the portal age.
Yeah, absolutely.
Texas, and you're not going to have it. You don't want to find out there.
No, we want to start fast, and you're right. We do have to. We have to hit the ground running, you know, when you have a whole bunch of new players like we've had the first 2 years, it's tough that first month, you know, and you kind of settle down after the preseason, you play your conference games with a little bit better idea of what you have. But you're right, we do have to start fast. And I think we know a lot more about our players than we've had the first 2 years. It's not a good feeling going into the season when you don't know what your players are all about. And these kids in the portal, some of them got scars. I mean, you don't find out about it until you get in really stressful situations. And And as a coach, that's no fun. And so anyway, you know, it's just the way things are right now. You know, we're really pressing forward these last 2 weeks. We want to see a lot of improvement. And we've talked a lot about, you know, getting closer as a team and supporting each other, make each other better. And I think we've been closer than we have in our first 3 years here.
Coach,